Hey guys, a very good evening to all my crypto peculiars. So have you all been curious about what's happening in the market? Don't you worry, the CoinMonks got you covered. Okay, so before starting with the update, let's quickly quote today's headlines. Jack Dorsey disses Ethereum, Web3 in Twitter rampage. Uniswap comes to Polygon, sending Matic to record high. Hong Kong NFT project Monkey Kingdom loses $1.3 million in phishing hack, launches compensation fund. Visa partners with 60 crypto platforms to allow crypto payments at 80 million merchants. So let's start off with our refresh feed. Firstly, despite being outspoken about his opposition to Ethereum, former Twitter CEO Dorsey is frequently questioned about his thoughts on the asset and the blockchain in general. It was one of these occasions that prompted Dorsey to reiterate his opposition to the digital asset. Well, let's have a look at what exactly happened with our headline being. Others have speculated that because Dorsey is putting all of his emphasis on creating with Bitcoin, the block CEO may include other blockchains into his work. C. Dixon, a Twitter user, raised the prospect of the CEO working with Ethereum and other blockchains once more, claiming that they were other uses of cryptocurrencies that would necessitate other chains. Dorsey had reacted to the tweet with a short and to-the-point message. The CEO emphasized that only safe and robust technology should be employed, alluding to the centralized structure of the Ethereum blockchain in another tweet that leaned heavily towards support for Bitcoin. I have faith in your capacity to comprehend systems. It's vital that we concentrate our efforts on truly safe and resilient technologies that are owned by the general public rather than by individuals or institutions. Only that foundation can support the applications you mentioned. The Ethereum blockchain was not the end of Dorsey's diatribe against centralized systems. Web3, the newest addition to the creative technological field, was also chastised by the CEO. He claimed on Twitter that people did not own Web3. Instead, it belongs to the VCs and LPs who are substantially investing in the industry right now. It is implied that the motivations of these VCs and LPs will always have an influence. The tweet itself had drawn criticism from those involved in the Web3 space who poured out to counter the views in the CEO. So moving ahead with our next coverage on Ethereum, Uniswap is one of the most popular decentralized applications. To assist lower transaction costs, its users opted to put out the protocol on Polygon as well. Let's have a look at what's getting cooked between these two with our headline being. The promise of decentralized finance, blockchain-based tools for lending, borrowing, and trading has been to allow individuals who have been shut down of the financial system to save and invest. Try explaining that to someone who is making their first deal on Uniswap, a decentralized exchange where costs to connect to the Ethereum network can exceed $100. Layer 2 Blockchain and Uniswap Polygon wants to make that anguish go away. Today, they revealed that Uniswap is now accessible on Polygon, a platform designed to relieve some of the burden of the Ethereum network. The holders of Uniswap's native Uni coin, which are mostly exchange users, run the exchange. They decisively decided last week to bring smart contracts from the V3 version of the protocol to Polygon. Today was the last day of the deployment. With this deployment, Uniswap, as the flagship Ethereum project, returns to its original promise of minimal costs and open access to everybody, stated Polygon co-founder Mihailo Jelic in a statement released today. This results in lower transaction costs, which is a huge plus for Uniswap customers who conduct all their buy and sell transactions on the blockchain. The attractiveness of decentralized exchanges is that you don't have to trust a third-party middleman like Coinbase or Binance to hold your assets in order to make trades. On the downside, you'll be responsible for network transaction costs. The average transaction cost on Ethereum hasn't dropped below $20 since early October, according to BitInfo charts. So moving forward with our next segment for today, with the support of a compensation fund, the Abused Non-Fungible Token Initiative hopes to rectify the wrongs before the holidays. Well, let's see what is the initiative with our inscription starting with. Monkey Kingdom, a Solana non-fungible token project backed by American DJ Steve Aoki, reported on Twitter on Tuesday that hackers stole $1.3 million from the community's crypto money through a security breach on Discord. The intrusion began with the vulnerability of Crape, a popular method for validating users on Solana, according to its makers. The vulnerability was subsequently utilized by hackers to gain control of an administrator account, which then posted a phishing link on the Monkey Kingdom Discord's announcement channel. Users that connected their wallets to the URL expecting to get an NFT were instead robbed of their SOL tokens by the fraudster. Unfortunately, the attack occurred just as users were preparing for the project's second release. Sun Wukong, also known as the Monkey King in Chinese tradition, is the heart of the Monkey Kingdom, which is made up of 2,222 algorithmically created NFTs. All earnings from the first sale of the NFTs were to be donated to a charity of one's choosing, with the goal of assisting Asian communities across the world. One Twitter user, known only as Comment Star, claimed to have lost 650 SOL as a result of the hoax. But it wasn't all doom and gloom. Monkey Kingdom's team has set up a compensation fund for victims and is on pace to fully pay individuals who have been harmed. The timetable and procedure for disbursing the monies have yet to be revealed. So wrapping up with our final segment, the Visa is back with the crypto news again. So apparently Visa has partnered with more than 60 leading crypto platforms like FTX, BlockFi, Crypto.com, Coinbase and Binance. Let's have a look at what they're up to. Visa's head of crypto revealed that the payments giant has teamed up with about 60 leading crypto platforms to launch card programs that make it easy for consumers to convert and spend digital currency at 80 million merchant locations worldwide. He emphasized that we've built a lot of momentum in this space and will continue to support the crypto ecosystem in several ways. In an interview with NDTV published on Monday, Kai Sheffield, Visa's head of crypto, discussed the payments giant's digital asset efforts. He started by saying that at Visa, the scale and scope of our work in crypto has grown dramatically. The number of people cross-functionally at Visa working on crypto in some capacity is now in the hundreds, up from just a handful of employees. And we've more than doubled our number of partnerships with crypto platforms in the last 18 months, up to 60 partnerships today. He further elaborated it by saying that we've partnered with more than 60 of the leading crypto platforms like FTX, BlockFi, Crypto.com, Coinbase, and Binance to launch card programs that make it easy for consumers to convert and spend digital currency at 80 million merchant locations worldwide. When asked if Visa plans to launch a crypto consulting service in India, the executive said no. However, early in December, the company announced the launch of its crypto advisory services. He conducted by saying, "We've built a lot of momentum in this space and will continue to support the crypto ecosystem in several ways." So we would now wind up with the assessment for today evening and meet you all tomorrow with even more interesting stuff. Until then, you may consider joining our Telegram channel for free crypto signals. Visit our blog linked below for guides, reviews and tutorials, and subscribe to the channel and get daily updates about the crypto market. Lastly, with this little favor of CoinMonks, we hope you stay updated. Thanks for watching and have a nice day ahead.